Do you remember when news broke about the possibility of oil in Jamaica? Do you remember the excitement for the potential financial gains amid concerns of possible exploitation? Well, in today's video, I will be doing a deep dive. I will be tracking the progress of oil exploration in Jamaica throughout the years, based on newspaper articles and other resources. I will end the video with the most recent developments and my thoughts. Did you know that 11 oil exploration wells were previously drilled in Jamaica? The first well was drilled in 1955 and the most recent was drilled in 1983. You see, it all began in 1924 when C.A. Matley, a geologist working with the government at the time, reported finding gas bubbles in a natural spring located in Windsor St. Anne. His paper was titled Report on a Mineral Spring at Windsor, St. Anne, and on the probability of the occurrence of petroleum in its neighborhood. But even with this hint of a probable oil find in this area, the first oil exploration well was not drilled here. It was drilled near Negril in 1955, because for some reason they could not gain access to the spring in Windsor. An exploration well was eventually drilled in Windsor, but 27 years later. It is currently the deepest onshore well drilled in Jamaica at a depth of 12,820 feet. Unfortunately, no commercial oil was found. Out of the 12 exploration wells previously drilled, 9 of which were completed onshore and 2 offshore, only one well did not contain hydrocarbons. Fast forward to 2014, when the most recent interest in oil exploration was reignited. In 2014, Petroleum Corporation of Jamaica PCJ entered into a production sharing agreement with Tullah Oil PLC. In 2016, the article Local Oil and Gas Exploration Enters Second Phase, which was published in the Jamaican Gleaner, revealed that PCJ and Tullah Oil PLC received approval from the National Environment and Planning Agency, NEPA, to explore Jamaican waters and have entered into an agreement with the fisherfolk to offer compensation if there are any issues. Apparently, at this time, the company entered into its second phase, which included the use of data collecting equipment in an effort to locate the best area to begin drilling. They used the equipment to get a two-dimensional seismic image of the seabed. In 2018, PCJ revealed that they discovered two different live oil spills in sections of Trelawney. At the time, they were hoping to attract explorers who would use their resources to engage in additional seismic and field research to confirm that it's a viable prospect, then commence with drilling. In response to concern that exploitation may take place, Brian Richardson, manager of oil and gas at the PCJ, confirmed that any oil found would be developed jointly with the government of Jamaica. This was said in an interview on TVJ's Smile Jamaica. In the 2018 JIS article, Jamaica to gain much if oil is found, Winston Watson, general manager of PCJ, is quoted as saying, "We looked at models all over the world to determine the best model to use to ensure that the country benefits. We have chosen the model where we present data about Jamaica, and if you, an exploration company, want to take a chance, then we are willing to share the spoils with you, but you have to put up the money and take the risk. The model we have has the country retaining a percentage with the company that does the investment getting a certain amount. As the production increases over time, the ratio may change where Jamaica will get more of it and the company gets less after they have recovered their costs," he explains. In addition, Tullah Oil performed the first 3D seismic survey to be done offshore in Jamaica in 2018. It was done on the south coast of Jamaica between Petro Banks and Portland Cottage. While preliminary data analysis showed positive indicators, there was not yet scientific proof of oil or gas. To confirm, they would need to drill to find oil deposits. However, at this point, they said the decision to drill would be made based on what the results are after the detailed assessment of the data, which was to be completed by the end of September 2019 and final decision made by 2020. In May of 2019, the article "No Oil Found in Jamaica" was published as PCJ tried to rubbish claims made by a newspaper columnist that approximately 229 million barrels of oil and gas were discovered offshore. PCJ held the position that even though they have found positive indicators of oil, they are not yet able to confirm an oil find. In August of 2020, United Oil and Gas PLC acquired Tullow Oil PLC's license to operate Jamaica's Walton Morant oil fields. They previously acquired 20% equity in 2017 and received permission in 2020 from the government of Jamaica to acquire the remaining 80% equity. In addition, a comprehensive technical evaluation of Jamaica's oil potential was carried out by Gaffney Cline and Associates, a leading petroleum consulting company with head office in England. This independent assessment commissioned by United Oil and Gas PLC concluded that Jamaica has what it describes as unrisked mean prospective resources of over 2.4 billion barrels of oil. What does that even mean? Well, my understanding is that they expect to be able to recover 2.4 billion barrels of oil in the event that oil is discovered in that area and eventually developed. This is based on 11 prospects and leads that have been identified and licensed to United Oil and Gas PLC. They were quick to indicate that this, however, doesn't mean that drilling of the prospective sites will take place, and even if they do take place, it doesn't mean that it will be done promptly. However, the article later points out that the government allowed United Oil and Gas PLC an extra 18 months to explore Jamaica's Walton Morant oil fields with the expectation that come January 2022, they will decide whether to drill or drop the project. So that was in 2020, now on to 2021. In May 2021, Darrell Vaz, the Minister of Science, Energy and Technology, confirmed that the exploration of oil and gas is still in progress. The May 19, 2021 article, "Oil and Gas Exploration Continues," offered more information on the project. You see, the entire exploration project, since they started in 2014, actually cost over $35 million. However, it is estimated that drilling an exploration well will cost anywhere from US $30 million to $40 million. As such, United Oil and Gas PLC is now conducting a worldwide marketing campaign to find an investor that will fund drilling of an exploratory oil well before January 2022 so they can drill by 2024. It's now February 2022. My research did not uncover any information as to where they are with the project at this time. Did they get an investor? Only time will tell. What are my thoughts? I believe that we need to assess the negative effects of oil and gas drilling and whether or not those effects are worth any type of financial gain. There are many countries that have paved the way in this arena, so we can use their experience as a guideline. The fact is, oil drilling can damage our marine ecosystems, destroy wildlife and their habitats, and release dangerous substances into the environment and dangerous emissions into the atmosphere. In addition, will the average Jamaican benefit financially from this fine?